My name is Bill Clark. I'm a retired chartered engineer, heading for my 91st year. I've had a full life without any problems, up to the point where I developed these heart problems with heart rate. But at 3 in the morning, my wife had to phone the ambulance because my heart rate and my blood pressure had gone completely out of control. My doctor had arranged an appointment with a consultant, and he said, the only way that we can cure this problem that you've got is by having a pacemaker fitted.
Well, the plan was to consider a two-stage approach to his management, which was to implant a pacemaker followed by an ablation of the electrics in his heart.
I had an interview for pre-op and I saw Professor Linker, and he brought in this small unit Medtronic pacemaker. And he thought that with the lifestyle that I led, it would be an advantage to me not to have the old type pacemaker, and would I be agreeable to going ahead and having the Medtronic unit put in.
Because he is a very active man, it was felt that a leadless pacemaker would have an advantage for him in that it would not restrict his activity, particularly of his upper body.
My frame of mind was, if this is going to be the answer, I will accept it. And I was looking forward to it.
I think the microimplant procedure is generally a fairly slick procedure from my perspective. So if you take a standard pacemaker implantation, you need to make an incision up, usually on the left side of the chest, put the lead in through the vein. All you have to do with a micro is get access to the vein, and then you're into the job of putting the micro into the heart. So I think it actually has the potential to simplify the procedure.
It's almost like you implant it and you can forget about it, but principally, it's managed in exactly the same way as another pacemaker from our perspective. And ideally that should be as light a touch on the patient as possible so that the implications and impacts on their life are as small as possible.
The advantage also of the Micra now is that the battery life is said to be very good. So you're looking at 10, 12 year battery life predicted for the device, which is very good. And this is an attractive alternative because the patients do feel very positive and they feel it's fantastic.
I don't feel any different. I don't even notice it. I forget all about it. It's only when I get a reminder to come up here that I realise that I've got it, sort of thing. Because my life hasn't changed. It's back to normal. So I would recommend it to people. I'm 90. Everything I get now is a bonus. And I said to my daughter when we came here, looking around at various people, I'm extremely lucky. I've got everything.